we wanted to create a platform that facilitates the transparency of the offering of tissues, and also a place where you can drop your request to see if there are already people offering a certain animal or tissue that you need. This demo environment is open for everybody, but the real environment is on atex.uu.nl. But this requires, at the moment, only the University of Utrecht account to log in, but we are connecting the UMC Utrecht as well. But this is still work in process. This is took a bit longer than we expected. So for now, we'll just use the demo environment since it's open for everybody and you can use the same set of features. There's some general info at the top, but the core of the platform is behind here. The request demo has a number of fake requests in the system, and the offer demo has a number of fake offers in the system. So not all of the information that you will see might be completely 100% correct, since I generated it and I'm not a researcher myself, but it just gives a gist of what you can expect. So we'll start off with the request demo. So the platform has a dashboard at the start, which lists the current number of requests that you've done here, or if you've made any offers, which I don't, but if you have, you will see your offers here. And your requests you can see here, and it lists some of the core features of your of the sort of tissues or animals that you requested. So this way you can always easily see what you have running. From here, the most logical flow would be to see, okay, I want to have a certain type of tissue or animal, and I want to see if the platform already has someone that is offering a certain type of animal that I'm looking for. So we'll go to look at offers. To accompany this, we've made an extensive filtering system with which you can search through all of the material in the database. So here you see 50 fake offerings that you can run through, and a whole lot of filters. So to see how the platform works, I'll start using some filters and putting them on and off, and you'll see the result list update in real time. So for instance, at the start, you can see, let's say I want conserved tissue, since that's all I need. And this acts like a hard filter. So you immediately see that only the conserved tissue is shown. And the same goes for the animal species. So we want a rat. Ah, there's one rat in the system currently. But if you switch it to guinea pig, it switches to, this is also one by chance. Let's see, there's more rabbits. No, also one. Or ferrets, zero. Or sheep. There's just one of every type. That's just a coincidence. But you can see that it's always is life changing. So this makes it quite easy to find the offering that you need. If you disable this one and just keep it a little bit more broad, let's say we just need some kind of organ, for instance, from a conserved tissue, but we don't care if it's from a cat or from a chicken. Then we can just select it like this. We select an organ, and it will just list all of the tissues that match one of these organs. And you can also see at the same time the match percentages. And this is an interesting feature that we specifically built for when the database will become larger. So if a lot of people start using the ATEX platform, we hope that there's a lot of material in the database and it should be very easy to find what you need. So to accompany this, we've built the match percentage. And this is a real-time updating percentage that will track what kind of filters that you have used and how many of those match with the results in the database. So for instance, we have now have four types of material that is 100% match. That's because we have these filters active. So we have it should be a conserved tissue. It should be 0 to 20 weeks old. It should contain a liver or a kidney. And we've requested one. Well, you can see here in the short preview that for these, at least the first three or four, it's a match. But this one, the most bottom one, is 45 weeks old. So it's still listed. So maybe you can still consider it. But the match percentage is lower, so it is sorted at the bottom. So the best matches are always listed first. And you can see this change in real time. So let's change the slider. Let's say go to 0 to 20 months. Then all of a sudden, all of these are within the same range. But what if we change the slider? Now we see the percentages change to make them all 75%, since every age listed here is pretty young. And you can see them here. 0 months is because it converts the weeks real time to months, and everything below 3 to 4 weeks is counted as zero currently. This way we can just slide it back and we have a perfect match again. But let's see if we can find a middle ground where some are high. Yeah, like this. So now we have two perfect matches and a couple less perfect. We can add some more preferences. So let's say SPF, causing more variety in the percentages. SPF it's also listed here in the column. Let's say we add storage. We have to have it frozen. Then there's still one match remaining. So this could be very handy to just find exactly the tissue that we need. In this case, conserved frozen chicken tissue that is between 2 to 12 months old and which has a liver or either a kidney as an organ. And sometimes when you select a lot of filters, it might not be clear to you why the percentage is the way it is. And to clarify this, we've built the select feature, which allows you to see, in this case, the 100% filter, you can see which column is the exact match. So in this case, all of these are a match. But if you go one back, and let's say go to the kettle one, the second one, then we can see this one is not a match because the SPF was unknown and the conserve date was not a match with the age range that we requested. So the specification page is just a way for you to investigate if this is really the material that you'd like. This is just an easier overview of all the features that we've built in. So you can also now see the string and the amount and a certain work protocol number and some extra information. This is now some randomly generated Latin, but maybe the person in question will add some specific request or specific demand here that you need to keep in mind when matching with this person. And you can also see the person that is responsible for this offer. So maybe we really want to expand ATX in the future so that more universities are going to use it. In that case, it will also be handy to see that there are more universities using it. And maybe you need a material that is only from UZ Utrecht and not from Radboud, or maybe even universities even more farther away. Then you can even keep those filters in mind in the future. There's also a nice graph which just represents the percentage listed here as well. So let's say we found our 100% match. You see that if you browse between the select page and the overview page, that it just keeps your filters. But this is all preserved in the link. So this way you will never lose what you were searching for. So this makes navigating back and forth very easy. So let's say we want this chicken. Then we say select match. Now we can fill in our own work protocol number here. So for the, this can be handy, I think, for the animal welfare body. So Wim and his colleagues can investigate if you really are really allowed to use this material. And once we are very happy and we are sure that we indeed wanted this type of material, you confirm. And we see the next pop-up of what the flow will be. We've created this small infographic to show what the rest of the process is, because the material needs to be exchanged, of course. And in this case, we found a match and we want to exchange the conserved tissue. So it's automatically approved. And this is not in the demo platform because you are not logged into your own account, but in the real environment, you will get an email that would give you the contact info of the person in question. And ATEX would also, so the secretaries of the ATEX platform would also get an email, and in the other flow, they would have to check and see if this procedure use case is the right way for when sharing that material. So that's how it goes. And then you see that we now have a match. So here in my matches, so we first we were here, and now under my matches, we can see our match that is not even more pending because it was approved automatically. And yeah, we would now be able to exchange the material with the other person. So here you can see it's request demo and offer demo. But in the real world, it would just be Judith and Dan, for instance. And we would have the contact info in our email. So we would not need the contact info in the platform itself. It just stays in your own secure environment. If you are not sure what the process was for exchanging material afterwards, or how the matching process works, in connection to the animal welfare body, you can always check out the infographic again here. So that is how the process in general works. There are all, we only used a couple of filters, but there are way more. So there's the string, which you can enter some cool Latin names in that I don't know. But it also illustrates a nice feature of the platform. So there are like, in total, there are about 8 columns. And by default, only 7 are active. But because we want to help people make the choice from the overview page and not have to switch back all the time, if not necessary, between the select page and the overview page, there's a sort of magic column that is added once you are using a certain type of filter. So in this case, string, you now can see that the string column here is added. And we can see if my Latin is matching the Latin required for the matching string. I'll now delete it. Like I said earlier with the type, there are some types of filters that are hard filters and some are soft filters, so the soft filters influence the match percentage, but the hard filters are so important or so demanding that it would be nonsense to let them influence the match percentage, because if you really want a live animal, then it will be useless to see the vital tissues or the conserved tissues. And we've made that choice for the gender as well. Once you select it, at least. So if you don't select it, you can always just leave it be. But if you select the gender or the sex, it will also hard filter all the others out. Like you see here, there's only males left, and now it's only females. So these three type, animal species and sex, are the three hard filters. I've illustrated the age as well. So these are, most are just very young. But to make the calculation easier, it will recalculate everything that is in system to the type of filter that you've active. So if you've selected months, it will recalculate the age to months as well. So that's a nice feature as well, I think. Then there's some nice details to know So in this case, we are searching for a certain amount of animals. So let's say we want 73 animals. Let's find someone lower. I'm going to make it a bit more clear. Like this. Okay, like this. Now we can see that the rat or the this mouse is only has 57. Only offered 57 mice, and thus we have 16 left. So what does the system do with that? If you select this one, and we are very happy with this one. We would select still. We want to have this one, these mice. Then we have another match, and we can see that it recalculated the match so that it now says 57 and 57. And now there should be a new request left in the system for 16. So if we open up our filters again, and there it is. It has reinserted the remainder of our request automatically into the system. So this way, you don't have any extra efforts to fix this yourself or to say, oh no, this one only has 57, so I have to manually look for the other 16 again. No, it will just insert this one, and this will allow other people to maybe fill in for these 16 requested mice. So this automation will hopefully make the process in general very easy to share animals between the researchers and labs. And our main goal for now will especially be for more people to start using the platform, because I can show the real platform now as well, or I'll just show the rest of this one here first. There's also the FAQ, which will answer most of your questions, and if some are missing, please let us know and we'll just add them as well. So this works very easily, and has a lot of categories, and tells you something about the privacy, so that it's very privacy friendly and you don't have to be afraid of that. And there's almost no cookies used, so only for logging in. So it's a very functional and privacy-friendly website, and all the data in the database is encrypted as well. So even if somehow a hacker would manage to get into the database, it would still be encrypted. So it would not be possible to see who used the platform. Yeah, that is the general gist of the platform. You can also, now we are really looking for something, but if you have an offer, it works quite the same way. Let's say I just want to see, or I just want to enter my material without looking in the current database, and you can also use the submit request and submit offer buttons here at the top. But as you can see, this works exactly the same, only the age is a different field. All these fields are pretty self-explanatory. And just add the numbers. That's a bit. And there we have it. It's now here. Even though we are in the request demo, we now have our first offer. So that's just very easy, and we can also copy it. So I can imagine many researchers often have the same sort of demands on a regular basis. But it's not so regular that you can say, I want to add this offer to the system or add this request to the system every 2 weeks. But to make it easy anyway, we've added the copy feature. So this will insert all of the fields of the previous one. let's say we need 12 this time, 13, 12. We can, oh, yes, you're right, just add in a number. And then we have 2. So that's very easily done and doesn't take any effort. So you can very easily use it. And because we've made a match, it also counts how many lives we've saved. So this stats counter hopefully will go up. Although I'm now thinking about it, the life saved doesn't really fit, but the match amount is actually what it is, not the number of amounts of animals that are included in the match. So this is the gist of the platform. So the main platform is here. This requires university account access, or at least a Solus ID at this time. So once we connect the UMC, it will show hopefully a UMC option as well, but because there's only one provider at this time, it will automatically go to the Utrecht University login page. So now you can see it will also see check my name. I don't have anything in the database yet because it's the live environment. But there is someone that did add one result. So yes, you can see there's not many people using it yet. So that's why we really want to give these workshops and showcase the platform and hopefully start a snowball effect, so that once more people start using it, it becomes more useful, and that's the snowball that we need. But there's someone who's using it, and it's he or she, I don't know, but he or she has entered 6 rats into the system. So that's perfect. That's just the way that we want to see it. So if there's now somebody who needs 6 mice from this certain strain, then go to ATEX with your Utrecht University account, and you can start creating the first match to the platform.
I think it's great. Maybe there are people who have questions.
Yes, they are very welcome.
If you want to ask a question, can raise your hand, or you can just speak up. Otherwise, it might be nice if people can try the demo themselves.
Yes, yeah. So, it's, like I said, it's just open, so everybody can log in onto the same account.
Ah, there's a question here from Armand. Is this just in Utrecht or available elsewhere?
It's currently sort of as a pilot, or it's just starting off now in Utrecht. And for now, it's only, like I said, the Utrecht University, but UMC will be connected as well. And from there, we'll just have to see. I think usefulness will only increase once we connect more universities, but we are now fixing most of the bugs in the platform in this phase. And I can imagine that Lim and Jan, who are Jan van der Valk, who is the leader, who are the leaders of this project, might want to extend the visibility of the platform later on, but I'm not sure what the time schedule for that is.
Maybe Wim, you can comment on that.
Yes, indeed, we do have the intention to extend it, and we know that some of the national institutes are interested in it. But we are now, you could say, somewhere in between letting loose step by step the old system that's giving information to researchers about supply animals available, and stepping over to this system. And we hope that in the next coming year, indeed, we will solve bugs that will be there. Of course, there will be questions raised we didn't think of. And take on board all these experiences to make the system better. And I can imagine that, and we also now are in the phase that we just saw one offer of chipmunk animals. But we will we would like also to start now with importing information on conserved tissues, because we do have a lot of freezers and other types of materials that are somewhere in the departments. Some of the initiators of this system already 2 or 3 years ago had also in mind just to focus on conserved tissues that are lying everywhere but hardly aren't used. So one of the next steps is also to discuss with researchers further how to include this information in the system. And if you succeed to do this, it would make the system more valuable. Another issue also is that we will also include animals that are suitable for replacement. So if there are chipmunk animals that are healthy, that are not hazardous to the environment or to other people, that are not genetically modified, are not too old, and are suitable for replacements, then we as animal welfare body could notice them in the system. And if they are not, if there is not a match for these animals in, let's say, 1 or 2 weeks, then we will seriously consider to replace them. And all these experiences we will take on board, and then, well, I don't know exactly when, but perhaps after a year or so, we could make next steps and to link with other establishments.
Jan?
Yes.
You're I think you double clicked on the mute button.
Oh, yes, I did. Thanks. the one thing we have to consider when we include other universities in our system is that when we talk about live animals, we have to consider transport stress. So the distances shouldn't be too long. And that also might be limit the involvement of international laboratories. But I think when the system is really working well, that we could copy the framework to other universities, and then they can use it locally. And only for conserved tissue, that we can do that at a much wider scale. So whole of Europe or even wider, because conserved tissue is relatively easily transported. Thanks.
Yeah, and in the chat, they are already suggesting to maybe put distance as another search criteria then, if other universities are added. And I see someone from Brazil who are also making a platform like this. So they are very happy with these experiences, and they really like the information about the lives saved on the dashboard. So great compliments, I think. Are there more questions? Otherwise, I would suggest that people can... I see something. Yeah, how will you announce when you will go nationally? Maybe Wim, I can give you, or Jan?
Yeah, I don't think we will go nationally. We will involve more and more universities, using their account system. So the local animal welfare bodies will probably inform the local people that they can now start using, from that time on, start using ATEX.
Yeah, so through the animal welfare bodies. There's another question. Can human tissue also be shared through this platform? For example, leftover tissue from surgeries.
That's an interesting one. Indeed, this platform could also be used to exchange human tissue. We do have contact with initiatives on these fields within the University Medical Center, the Department of Anatomy and Lung Diseases. And for this moment, we do not know exactly whether we will continue as one platform, or that we will go into the direction of a network of platforms. But we surely do have the intention to link these initiatives, at least to link these initiatives together, because in fact it is one continuum, you could say, whether you work with animal tissue or human tissue. And especially last year when with this corona, we saw an acceleration of people coming from the veterinary institutes, for instance, cooperating together with researchers from the human side. So yeah, sure, we want to investigate the possibilities that are there, whether on this platform or linked to other platforms.
Yeah, and technically
yeah, and
it's quite easy as well.
And I think I can add, we are in close contact with the Vital Tissue Initiative, which is an initiative to stimulate and facilitate the exchange of human tissue. So that might be helpful also in the future.
Dan, you wanted to add something as well?
Yeah, the technically it's also quite easy for us to add it, because the whole system is just based on certain decision trees. So you make a choice, let's say that you have an animal, or let's say you could select there that you want a human or a human tissue. Then it will can easily change all of the fields shown to filter the material in the system. So let's say human tissue has all kinds of different categories that you need, maybe a certain type of surgery I don't know the specifics about the human tissues, but this will be very easy for us to implement. So this makes the platform very dynamic, I think, in the future. Or even as Wim says, you can also make a separate platform, of course, for the human tissues, because most, I don't know how many times researchers can choose between either a human tissue or an animal tissue, but maybe if that use case occurs a lot, then it would make a case for combining them. But if not, then I would separate them, I think. And ATEC is a bit of a weird name for the human tissue, or the human is a kind of animal as well.
We're all the same. So there's another question in the chat. How can you encourage more people to use the platform? A coordinated media campaign or newsletters? That might also be a question for Wim or Jan.
Yeah, I think it is and. So we started with a small group with repeated information in our newsletter, the newsletter of the Animal Welfare Body, you know, the VR Center, but also presentations like this on congresses, on the for the Animal Welfare Body Network. We do have, as an animal welfare body, once in a year or in 2 years, roundtable visits at research groups, and then we pay attention to it. So I think we must use several channels. And indeed, as Dan said, I think it will be a kind of a snowball. It's starting slowly up now, but at the moment that people find a way, and we do have good examples, we can advertise with experiences from researchers, and then hopefully it will be starting to grow.
Thank you. Maybe I can reverse the question also for the people who are in this workshop. What would you need to actually submit an offer or a request to this platform? If you have any input, put it in the chat, or you can speak up or email it to us as well, I think, because that information can be very valuable to increase the amount of offers that are now in ATEX.
Yeah, or missing features in general, indeed.
Yeah. So yeah, Armand is saying an active large database will keep people looking over and over. So indeed, you need a sort of starting point to attract people, I guess, to ATEX and even add more. Yeah.
Yeah, the other thing is when we when protocols are submitted for animals that are meant to be a donor for tissue, we can in the first instance also refer those people to the ethics database before we start further putting those protocols into the system, the license system.
Yeah, really great suggestion. I see still. Yeah,
Wim? Yeah, one thing to mention perhaps also is that we want to use it as a kind of a catalog for strains that are available. So regardless whether or not at a certain moment there are surplus animals for these strains, but to use it as a catalog for researchers that they know what kind of strains there are available within the establishment. And that could also be interesting for in future for researchers from other institutes.
Yeah, it can also be used for searching different kinds of animals that are used for experiments.